guys, welcome to today's video and welcome on into my beauty stash. Today I have another new foundation to try out for you guys, and this comes to me from a brand that I have never tried anything from, and it is RMS Beauty. I picked up their new Re-Evolve Natural Finish Foundation. This foundation retails for $48. You can find it on the Sephora website. I had ordered mine from the RMS Beauty website since that's when it first dropped. And the bad thing about this foundation, well, maybe it's a good thing, maybe it's a bad thing, I don't know. It only comes in 16 different shades. So I almost didn't get it just because of that reason. I was thinking, well, is there gonna be room for everybody to find something within this foundation? Because it's not a skin tint. You know, sometimes with skin tints, you can get away with a shade range like that. But nevertheless, here we are. I have it in my hand. I'm actually wearing it. This is day two that I have it on, and we're gonna give it a shot. You know, I was curious. You guys know I love doing foundation reviews, and maybe this is something that can work for some, maybe not all, but who knows? Who knows? I do want to point out that this is you twist it like this to get the pump up, but it's also a refill. So this pops up and then you can just buy the refill. I like that. I think that is a good idea. Now, this is gonna provide a natural finish, which I love a natural finish foundation. You're gonna get medium buildable coverage out of this one. The shade that I picked up is shade 11. And I think it's a really nice shade match for me. So I'm very happy so far with the shade. I like that also on the box, I have some details about it. Sometimes they don't include that. That way I don't have to reach for my phone. Let me just read you some of the things that it has. Some of you are really gonna like this. It is a silicone-free foundation. It is infused with skincare. It's a liquid foundation. It's gonna provide a fresh feeling, and it's going to be easy to blend. Now, I typically apply my foundations with my favorite BK Beauty 101 foundation brush. This is going to deliver smooth, long-lasting, medium coverage while it hydrates, firms, and softens the complexion. Now, this foundation also includes squalene, and it includes, what did it say here? Soothing organic aloe. So it's gonna be hydrating while still helping to blur and to give us that good medium buildable coverage. So I'm really excited for this one. You guys know I live for doing foundation reviews. If it is your first time here on my channel, first and foremost, hello and welcome. My name is Steph. I do lots of new makeup reviews, especially foundation reviews, multiple looks with new eyeshadow palettes. If that sounds like something you want to see on pretty much a daily basis, because I do upload quite a bit, do me a favor, click on the subscribe button, go ahead and hit the bell notification icon so you'll get a notification every time I do upload a new video. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up on your way out. But I am 40 years old and I have normal to oily skin. I am oily primarily in my T-zone, with my nose being the oiliest place on my face. I do have some old acne scars and minor discoloration on the sides of my cheeks, so this is the area that I tend to build up or just add extra coverage to. I love a natural finish foundation, but I also like a matte finish. I like a dewy finish. I like all different types of finishes. I even enjoy powder foundation and skin tints. So I just like to try everything. I even like to try foundations that are not intended for my skin type, because you never know. You never know until you try it. And I'm here to try it all for you so you guys don't have to. When I choose a shade, I usually go like fair to light, and I'm usually choosing like a neutral undertone, sometimes a warm undertone. So if that helps you make a good shade buying decision, I will insert a picture of what the makeup looks like outdoors. That way you can see. I know some of you have said that has been very helpful as well. And of course I will insert some swatches comparing this to other similar foundations that I have in my stash. So hopefully that can help you make a good shade buying decision. This might be available only online right right now. So I know those photos can definitely, those swatch photos can help a lot of you out in case this is something that you've had your eye on. Again, this is a like brand first impression for me because I've never tried anything from RMS Beauty. I've heard that their blushes are really amazing. So I think that'll be my next purchase from the brand. But this is going to be a 2-day, 10-hour wear test. The way I do my wear test is on day one, I don't wear this with any primer, powder, or setting spray. I also try not to do like any blush or bronzer, but if I do have to, which I did have to in today's video, I do like cream-based products, and like I didn't even put any highlighters. So I look for a foundation that lasts 10 hours because that's a typical work day for me, 10 hours, including like the travel time and stuff. If my foundation can look great for that amount of time, whatever it needs to do after that, then so be it. On day two, I do wear it, which is today, I do wear it with, you know, the rest of my makeup. I do my makeup the traditional way that I always do my makeup. And of course, you guys know I do my periodic check-ins throughout the day, letting you see how it's wearing on my 40-year-old normal to oily skin. And of course, at the end of the video, we'll wrap up everything. I'll give you some alternatives in case the $48 price tag is not in your budget. I got you covered. I think I got you covered. I think I have a good enough feel for this foundation to kind of make some comparisons to other things that I have in my stash. So hopefully that will be able to help you guys make a good shade buying decision. And guys, of course, I will have everything that I'm using both on and off camera linked and listed in the description box. Some of those links might be affiliate links. So if you do end up shopping through them, I thank you so much for supporting me and my channel. Let's get this foundation party started. If you guys want to see the new RMS Beauty Re-Evolve Foundation in action for the next 2 days, keep on watching. Okay guys, let's go in with this Re-Evolve Natural Finish Foundation. Love the packaging. Very nice. Give it a good shake. All right, so we just turn it and the pump goes up. Okay, so let me... Okay, not a lot comes out with this pump. Okay, that's all I managed to get out right now. I'm gonna do the right side of my face with my BK Beauty 101 foundation brush, which, by the way, I believe the BK Beauty anniversary sale is still going on. I think that's a good shade match. So the BK site is 20 to 35% off. I'll have my affiliate link in, well, it's always in the description box in case you want to reference it. So already I like that this is a natural finish foundation and that it is going to give us medium coverage. Those are two of my favorite things in a foundation. I'm also excited to be trying this brand for the first time. And once again, day one, I don't wear this with any primer, powder, or setting spray. I will likely do a little bit of cream blush and cream bronzer. I'll skip the highlighter, but I do have, I have like three different eyeshadow palettes that, actually four different eyeshadow palettes. Two are coming in today, two came in yesterday, so I gotta film with at least one of them today. So you guys will be seeing a couple different eye looks probably throughout this video. And those videos will, some of them will be up before this one, so stay tuned for that. Okay, so here is what the right side looks like. No foundation. I think it looks nice. I think it looks really good. I definitely see a medium coverage. I definitely see, what does it say? It's like a satin, natural satin finish. I can definitely see that. And I do like it with the brush. Like, I almost hate to have to use the sponge because I know it's just going to be so much better with the brush and I don't have much left. So let me just pick up what I can. Definitely, if you want to sheer it out, then use the sponge. But if you want to get the medium coverage, maybe even a little bit more than medium, you're going to need to use the brush, and then you can press over everything with the sponge. And I am already out. So I need to get a little bit more. I really like this shade. Once again, it's shade 11. I think it's a really nice shade match. The sun, it's early in the morning. Well, it's about 8:30. It's early for a Saturday morning. But Saturday morning is usually when I do my chores. So I just woke up. I woke up at 7:30. Did a few chores, and now I'm getting ready for the day. Okay, so this is what it looks like with the sponge. I'm going to take my brush, and I always build up coverage right here on the sides of my cheeks. That's where I have old acne scars and minor discoloration. And then I will press over it with the sponge. Okay, so let me take a closer look at this. Oh, I need to clean my mirror. But I think that looks really pretty. Wow. Looks really nice. It kind of almost reminds me of the new Hourglass foundation, like the finish of it. Maybe it'll last longer. That one is a beautiful foundation, the Hourglass, the soft ambient, what is it, the glow one, but it doesn't get me a good 10 hours. And all of my foundation reviews and wear tests are 10 hours. You know, it's just a typical work day for me, so I always, you know, just make sure it gets me 10 hours. I'm going to go in now with the Dior Forever Skin Correct. I have the shade 1, I think I use shade 1W, 1N. I use shade 1N. I'm just going to do some concealer under the eye area. I'm just going to add a little bit of Too Faced Peach Perfect Setting Powder to the under eye area. Okay guys, so here is how the complexion is looking. I think it looks beautiful. I'm very impressed. Wow, what a great first brand impression, RMS Beauty. I think this foundation looks absolutely beautiful. So again, I'm not going to add any powder, no setting spray. I am going to do a little bit of cream bronzer and cream blush. I won't do any highlighter. I'll be back later on in the day. After lunch, we'll do the midday check-in. And of course, at the end of this day one wear test, I'll let you see how the makeup is looking, give you my initial first impressions. And then we'll do this all over again tomorrow. So stay tuned. Hey guys, 5 hour check-in here with this new RMS foundation. This is how the complexion is looking. So I only added blush and bronzer and of course my eye makeup, but I didn't do any highlighter or anything like that today. I feel like my nose is looking a little shiny. I mean, it's not totally there yet, but I do feel, and I've kind of noticed that like the last couple hours that my oil is starting to come through just a little bit, maybe a little bit on my forehead as well. But overall, I think it is wearing pretty good. Like it looks really smooth. I like the finish of it. You know, it feels really lightweight, comfortable. It's not really tacky. Like it kind of just set itself down, maybe just a little bit, but I've definitely had other foundations during day one that they feel a lot tackier than this does. So this seems pretty good. I think those of you with dry skin, I think you might appreciate this quite a bit, but it still has 5 more hours to go. So I'll check in with you guys at the end of this day one wear test. We'll see how it looks and then we'll take it from there. Hey guys, 10 hour check-in here with this new one from RMS Beauty. I'm definitely shiny. My oil has definitely come through and the makeup is starting to break up like all in here and in through here. And that's just because, you know, I'm a normal to oily skin type. The oil is starting to, you know, come through. I don't have any powder on my face other than what's under my eye area. I do like the finish of this quite a bit. And I think if you are a dry skin type, normal to dry,
full-on dry, I think you might really appreciate this because it does dry down pretty well. Like right now it doesn't even feel tacky, and sometimes foundations that I don't powder down will still feel tacky at the 10-hour check-in, just the way they do at the 5-hour check-in, but this one seemed to do pretty good. I think this is gonna look so much better, or just wear so much better on me tomorrow when I pair it with primer, powder, and setting spray. And of course I will do that like 1-hour check-in in the morning, letting you guys know everything that I applied to my complexion. But you know, I'm excited for this one. I don't think it did terrible. It did the way I guess I was expecting it to do without wearing those helping products. So I definitely have higher expectations for it tomorrow, and I will check in with you guys then. Good morning, guys. Here is day 2 trying out the new RMS foundation. I'm actually trying a new concealer today too. I'm using the new one from REM Beauty. This is Ariana Grande's beauty line. They just dropped 60 shades of concealer. I picked up 2 of them. So I have shade light 2N under the eye and shade light 6N right here on the sides of my cheeks. You guys will see that wear test go up probably after this video goes up, because that's gonna be a 2-day wear test. But the complexion is looking beautiful, I think. I think this foundation looks much better. Actually, it looked great yesterday, but for me, I feel much better in it because I used primer, powder, and setting spray. So for primer, I went in with the Fenty Pro Filter Primer. And for powder, I went in with the Urban Decay All-Nighter Loose Setting Powder. Definitely powdered down the T-zone. Since I'm doing this concealer wear test, I only powdered down this under eye area. But yeah, guys, I am liking the way it looks. And then for setting spray, I went in with the new one from MAC. This is the Fix Plus Stay Over Alcohol-Free Long-Lasting Setting Spray. I've really been enjoying this one. And this is how it looks. I'm liking it. I think it looks really pretty. It feels still a little bit tacky, but then again, I didn't powder down like right over here, but everywhere else, I think it looks pretty good, and you get a really good amount of coverage, and it does feel really lightweight on the skin. I have very high expectations for this one. So far, I'm loving the finish of it, but it still has 9 more hours to go. I will be back later in the day to do the midday check-in, and of course, at the end of this day 2 wear test, so we can wrap everything up and I can share with you my final thoughts on this new RMS Beauty foundation. Hey guys, 5-hour check-in here on day 2, and here's what my complexion is looking like. It's a really pretty foundation. A really pretty foundation. It wears well. It feels lightweight. I don't necessarily see it like settling into any fine lines, accentuating any texture. I think it looks nice. It feels nice. I do think I'm a little shiny on my nose. And keep in mind, I don't do any touch-ups when I do these wear tests. So normally, like, I would touch up right now, but I'm not. But I think my forehead looks really smooth. I love the coverage. I love the shade. I love the finish. So far, it's been doing really good. But it has 5 more hours to go. I'll be back at the end of the day, and we'll wrap up this 2-day, 10-hour wear test trying out the new RMS Beauty Re-Evolve Natural Finish Foundation. Hey guys, we've come to the end of this 2-day, 10-hour wear test trying out the new RMS Beauty, Re-Evolve Foundation. This is how the complexion is looking. And I kind of feel like it looks very similar to how it looked yesterday. And keep in mind, today is the day that I wore it with, you know, all of the helping products. But I do see the same thing happening. Like right here, it's already started to break up a little bit around my nose. I definitely think my nose is still shiny, and my forehead, it looks okay, but it is getting, you know, a little bit shiny. Again, I don't do any touch-ups when I do these foundation reviews. So this is how the skin looks, you know? I feel like that this foundation is going to be best suited for those of you with normal to dry skin, maybe even full on dry skin. Keep in mind, it is a hydrating foundation. And while I think it looks really pretty, I do think it has a beautiful finish to it. I don't feel like it, you know, accentuates any texture. I do think that it has caused me to get excess oily a little sooner than I would have liked, even wearing powder and primer with it. This is definitely a foundation that when I wear it going forward, I'm gonna have to touch up midday and maybe towards the end of the day. Other than that, guys, I mean, you know, it looks all right. Like, it doesn't look terrible. I've definitely had foundations that look worse at this time. Like, it looks okay. Like, I'm not mad about how it looks. I am definitely gonna keep this and keep on wearing it. I just think it could look a little bit better. Now, in the swatch portion of today's video, I did compare this to 5 other foundations that I currently have in my stash. And these were foundations that just kind of reminded me of this new one from RMS Beauty. The first one that popped into my mind was the latest from Hourglass, the Ambient Soft Glow. This is a beautiful foundation. It's a beautiful foundation. Unfortunately for me and my normal to oily skin, it only gets me about a good 8 hours. I mean, it'll look okay at the 10-hour mark, but for $58, I kind of expected it to look a little bit better. They both wear very similar. So if you're trying to decide between either or, I mean, either one you go with, I don't think you're going to be disappointed. They're both beautiful foundations, but are they going to look great for the full 12 hours plus that you need it to? Maybe not. I mean, for me and my normal to oily skin, I think these both work great for a good 8 hours. At the 10-hour mark, and especially if you're not doing any touch-ups, you're going to see those signs of wear. So I think if you do touch-ups throughout the day, I think you should be good with either one. The Hourglass is 58, the RMS is 48. So I'll let you make up your mind regarding those. I also wanted to point out the latest one from NARS. This is the Light Reflecting Foundation. This is also another natural finish with a slight glow. I like this foundation a lot. This will get me a good 8 to 10 hours. I feel like these kind of wear the same and they do provide the same amount of coverage. I don't remember offhand how much the NARS is. I definitely think it's over $40. This one might be less expensive than this one from RMS Beauty, but if you already have this one, you might not feel the need to pick this one up or even to try out the Hourglass one. Another one that I thought of when I was doing this wear test is this one from Chanel. This is the Le Beige, Healthy Glow Foundation. And this is also a hydrating foundation. This is going to also provide a natural finish. This is a beautiful foundation. I would say that out of the 3 I just spoke about, this is the longer wearing foundation of the bunch, but it is also the more expensive of the bunch. This one is going to cost you at least $60, but it's also another beautiful foundation. If you need something more on the affordable side, I really enjoyed this one from Morphe. This is their Filter Effect Soft Focus Foundation. You're going to get a good medium coverage out of this. This one does last a good 10 hours on my normal to oily skin. This one is a really pretty foundation from Morphe. I want to say this one retails for like between $18 and $22. So it's not bad. It's a nice foundation. I'd highly recommend checking this one out. And then at the drugstore, I thought about this one from Physicians Formula. This is the Butter Believe It Foundation. This one says it's good for all skin types. It's also going to provide a natural finish. You're going to get a good medium to full coverage out of this one. This one will give me 10 hours. Is it going to look spectacular at 10 hours? You know, maybe, maybe not. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. I would say that out of all of these foundations that I just showed you, the one that will for sure get me a really nice 10-hour wear is the Morphe one. So those are my thoughts, guys. Those are my recommendations, dupes, alternatives for this new one from RMS Beauty. You can find this right now on the RMS Beauty website. It will be available at Sephora on August the 9th. I thought it was already available, but it's actually August the 9th when you'll be able to buy it. So I will have it linked to both places in the description box. And let me know what you thought about this foundation review. What are your favorite RMS Beauty products? This is my first time trying the brand. It's definitely not going to be my last. I really like the foundation. I think it's a beautiful finish. I just think it's going to be best suited for those of you on the drier skin type. But let me know your thoughts. Sound off in the comments down below. I want to thank you guys so much for watching another one of my videos. You all have a great day or night, wherever it is you all are at. Stay hydrated, guys. Drink that water. And I will see you all very soon. Bye.